omega-3s, fish oil, krill oil, which one should you take? But most importantly, when should you take it? One of the things you're going to do when you look at supplements and you compare, you're going to look on the back of the supplement label. You're going to go, what's the dose? How much is in there? But what if you don't absorb it? So it's not just the dose, but should you take it with fat? Should you take it in the evening? Because a lot of people take it for their heart. It's cardioprotective. We talk about skin and beauty on this channel, but a lot of people take it for the heart. And we know most heart attacks occur when? In the morning. What about taking it at night? People are on cholesterol-lowering drugs, aspirin. They often take them in the night to prevent those morning events. And what about reflux? Should you freeze it? There are people that freeze their fish oil to delay absorption because people might burp it up. Some fish oil gets rancid. What about krill? Should you take it? What are the benefits over fish oil? And what's astaxanthin all about? This and more in today's video. Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking fish oil and krill oil. When should you take them? If you take a supplement, it's very important to know how and when to take it to get the best absorption and to avoid side effects so that you can tolerate it. Krill and fish oil are omega-3 fatty acid supplements that have been linked to a number of health benefits. I much prefer krill because it has astaxanthin. It's a smaller tablet, so if you take a jar, the jar overall is going to be smaller. Why? You need less oil. So it's a tiny tablet. I don't know if you can see it. But a lot of people take fish oil and it's a larger tablet. It's hard to swallow it. So that makes a difference for people because the best tablet, of course, is the one that you're going to take. It has astaxanthin. And astaxanthin is one of the most powerful antioxidants on earth. It's also more bioavailable. That's why you need less of it in the tablet. And krill oil is less likely to be rancid. So those are just a few of the benefits of krill versus fish. Whichever one you're taking, whichever one you like, this video will help you. Studies show that fish oil can do several things, and that's why people take it. Reduce inflammation, help with dry eye and redness, improve heart health, protect brain function. The studies are still ongoing, of course, and I keep you updated with the latest. Now, right off the bat, a common problem with fish oil, people are going to want to take it with the rest of their supplements first thing in the morning. I'm going to tell you why that isn't good, and as well, if you're taking it for your heart, stay tuned for number 4 because there's important information. And sleep. Yes, it can affect your sleep, it seems. The number one thing to consider is acid reflux. Some people get acid reflux with this, and it's a side effect associated more with fish oil than krill oil, but it's thought to be due to the fact that there's fat content, of course, in the fish oil. And when you eat it, the oil kind of in the stomach goes to the top, just like oils do. They rise to the top. And when it's floating on top of the stomach, of course, the stomach wants to then digest things, and it releases enzymatic reactions from the pancreas and gastrin and all those things that can make reflux worse. So if you're taking it with other oils, often this can help. But better yet, and shown in the studies, is splitting your fish oil into 2 smaller doses and taking some in the morning and some at night with food. It's an effective strategy that can help prevent the reflux and indigestion. Again, it's less important than with krill. And if you want to look at a study on generally how to take it, I'll put one right here. It's called a prescriber's guide, and that might be something worth looking at. That leads me into food. You should take it with food. Regardless if you take fish or krill, it's important to take it alongside a meal with fats, preferably healthy fats. That's going to help increase the bioavailability and enhance the effectiveness. Taking it with food is also beneficial, as it has been shown that consuming fish oil immediately before the meal can reduce the acid reflux and indigestion. So if you just take it with water, sometimes then you get more chance of the indigestion, or if you take it at night on an empty stomach. Some users also report that taking fish oil with food prevents them from having diarrhea, belching, and nausea, but that's more variable. It's not as predictable as with the reflux. A third problem why people don't take it, they burp it up. One of the things is you can freeze it. A lot of people freeze it and then take it, it delays the absorption in the stomach, so it absorbs a little further down the intestinal tract. Again, this is something more common with fish than krill because you're just getting more product in a larger tablet versus the krill. Let's talk about what time of the day taking it with a fatty meal. A lot of people take their supplements with breakfast, but this is a problem because a lot of people are taking low fat breakfast. They moved away from things like eggs and egg yolks, even though they contain valuable K2 in the egg yolk. People are taking grains and cereals. There's not a lot of fat there to help with the digestion of the fish oils and krill. It's for this reason I recommend most people take it in the evening time with or around supper. And there's another reason for this. Several studies have now shown that taking aspirin and cholesterol lowering drugs, as well as blood pressure and anti-reflux medications, may work better in the evening. As well, most heart events, heart attacks often lead to a fluttering of the heart that's not conducive to blood flow as well. Most of those events occur in the morning hours. So the belief is taking these at night, you'll have your maximal antiplatelet effect by the morning time. Now certainly fish oil works over time, so it is important to be consistent with it, but that might be one reason that people would consider taking it at supper, so it's maximum effective time if you're using it for heart and heart safety would be in the morning when the risk of having that event is higher. Now let's talk about sleep. Not a lot of people think about sleep with this, but a pilot study from UK researchers found that children who supplemented with omega-3s increased their sleep time by an average of 58 minutes while reducing the number of wake-ups throughout the night. Other studies have similarly shown that omega-3 is important for good quality rest and improved relaxation and a lower risk of sleep apnea. Very common sleep apnea now. So many people have it. Obesity and weight problems are profound. Overall, I do not want you to overthink this. Just take it if you're short on time. If you're a routine person, consider the things that I mentioned. Just like skincare and facial treatments, consistency is key. The worst supplement you can purchase, or skincare, or anything, is the one that you do not use, and that is a complete waste of money. People don't use things either because they're side effects, they don't work, or they just don't do what they said they've done. So buying quality and something that you're going to use consistently helps remove that variable. Find a time that works for you and take your fish oil or krill oil, preferably krill, consistently to maximize its benefits. As usual, be sure to discuss any new supplement with your healthcare provider first, especially if you have underlying conditions. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.